Now, the union members we talked to in Wisconsin and also in Ohio, Governor, they say they've given concessions and made changes in health care that have helped save the state millions and millions of dollars. In fact, they say we've been giving and giving, but at what point do you want to stop?
Bill, let me just give you one example.
How do you respond to
our
that,
average?
Governor?
Yeah, our average private sector employee pays 23% for their health care. Our average city worker in Ohio pays 9%. Now, look, this is about ending the promises that get made that can't be fulfilled. But it's about more than that, Bill. We have to give local government officials a way to be more efficient and more effective in the delivery of services, and we have to give them the flexibility they need to manage their costs, including labor. If they want to give the people that work in their city more money, they can do that. But what we shouldn't do is have a thing like binding arbitration, where an outsider comes in, imposes a settlement on a city that the city can't afford, and then they got to raise taxes, and when they raise taxes, they drive jobs out. And by the way, your precious city of Cincinnati has lost 40% of its population since 1950. I mean, that's nearly 10% a year. So, Bill, we have to stop the drain. You cannot cut your way to prosperity, but you can set the table for economic growth, and that is exactly what I am all about, job creation.